Economics, and this is your last chapter, that is globalization and Indian economy. And in the previous chapter in agriculture, we have discussed a lot about globalization. I think you must be familiar about the globalization, everybody.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you aware about what is globalization?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So now, first thing I want to discuss about, because it is totally related with the economics, because it affects the economy also. So your chapter is related with MNCs. Starting of the chapter of economics, chapter number 4, globalization. Started with the introduction of MNCs. I think you all have heard about the MNCs. Can anybody tell me the meaning of MNCs? What do you
mean? Multinational companies.
Okay. Multinational companies or corporation. But what is that? This is the meaning. This is the full form of MNCs. What do you mean by MNCs? What do you mean by MNCs?
Company which have their branches in different nations.
Yes. Yani the company which is having production more than one nation. If you will go with the name MNC. M means multi, yani more than one national. Yani not only one nation, it is more than one nation. And company, automatically when whatever they are producing goods or services. So automatically, the country which is having production more than in one nation, that is called MNC. As consumers, in today's world, some of us have a wide choice of goods and services before us. If you will discuss with your parents also, and you should discuss, because nowadays parents are also having enough time to sit with you. So you just discuss with them. There was a time when very few consumer goods were available in the market. Very few consumer goods. Ab consumer goods kya hai? What are consumer goods? Which we require for our life of consumption. And we all are consumer here. Everybody is a consumer. Even the producer is also a consumer. So in that conditions, if we will go with the before 1990, so automatically we will find that very few consumer goods were available. Now we can see in Indian market also, the latest models of digital cameras, mobile phones, TVs, made by the leading manufacturers of the world are within our reach, isn't it? They are within our reach. We can buy easily, no problem at all. Even we are not aware what is happening in our neighbors, but we are aware what is happening around the world. What is the reason behind this? That is this globalization. Every season, new models of automobiles can be seen on Indian roads. Aati hai nayi gaadiyan. Gone are the days, and there was a period when you will discuss with your parents, they will also tell you about. Gone are the days when Ambassador and Fiat, that were the only cars on Indian roads. Only two cars, Ambassador and Fiat. Maruti became up around 90s. Today, Indians are buying cars produced by nearly all the top companies in the world, isn't it? And we are not facing any problem. And a similar explosion of brands can be seen for many other goods, from shirts to televisions to processed fruit juices. And this wide-ranging choice of goods, whenever we visit to the market, lots of goods are in the market, but it is a recent phenomenon. Before 1990, such a variety of goods were not available in the market. That means in a matter of years, our markets have been transformed. But if you will see in present scenario, again, our Prime Minister declare that is vocal to local. So first we have to look within the country, and after that we'll go beyond that domestic market. So now we'll share the screen. And you just see. One second. Have you ever seen these companies and banks in India? I think everybody is aware about this, isn't it? आप लोगों ने देखा माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वेरी फेमस जॉनसन मैकडॉनल्ड्स एंड आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम यू वांट टू गो टू द मैकडॉनल्ड्स दीज आर अमेरिकन कंपनी बट इट इज एक्सेसिबल टू ऑल द सिटीजंस ऑफ द कंट्री. All are very familiar. All these brands are very familiar. These are yes, also sir. MNCs. That is UK company. How is it possible that foreign companies are established in Indian market? And what is the reason? And who is responsible for this?
And that globalization.
Is globalization. So I think it is clear to all that globalization means integration. Integration of
countries.
Our country within
to another
the other countries, between countries, among countries is called
globalization.
And this is your history chapter also. Whatever the history chapter will do in is chapter number 4. The name of the chapter is Making of a Global World. That means it is not a new phenomenon. So now we'll discuss about production across countries. Production across countries. So there are, we can divide into two phases. That is before globalization. Before globalization means till the middle of the 20th century. And middle of the 20th century, that means Second World War. About Second World War, because Second World War was ended in 1945. Production was largely organized within the country. And what was moving? Countries were trading. Trading was there, but only limited items like raw materials. Like we are talking about the, we have discussed about East India Company also. What were they trading? Raw materials, foodstuffs, and finished products. So these is the production across country before globalization. Now again, I want to are you getting my voice?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, we have some screen problem is there. Okay. So now again, I want to show something. And that is, you just see this again. Globalization and Indian economy. Globalization. Now being globe. Pandemic has changed the situation. Instead of global, it converts into local. So now, out of the food items that have been displayed in the field, which is not found in India, you just see burger, pizza. These are not Indian food. But still, it is the part of our daily life. Is the dress that we are wearing is our tradition? Even culture is also intermixed. Boys are wearing kurtas along with the jeans. Is it Indian tradition? Is the language that we are speaking is of Indian origin? So think about some other areas like education, employment, production, culture. So all these things are transformed. So globalization has affected our culture. Sometimes we can say when we will discuss about the impact of globalization and especially negative impact. That means the culture, you have heard the word soil erosion. What do you mean by this? Soil erosion? What is soil erosion?
Top layer.
Okay. But in the globalization reference, when we are talking about this is a very detailed topic. When we will discuss about the negative impact of globalization, so cultural erosion is also one of the most important points, isn't it? Because it has transformed our culture also. Western countries are adopting Indian culture and we are forgetting. Bol rahe na? I think you all are aware about it, isn't it? Cultural erosion ho raha hai. And the main reason behind this is only globalization. Globalization affected the society also, politics also. Politics kaise kar raha hai? Now you see, whatever is doing by our neighboring countries, and we are taking all these issues on the international level, isn't it? Now we are talking about the WHO, ye kar raha hai, wo ye kar raha hai. What is this? World Bank, little bit we have discussed about economy to hai ye pick. Environment also, anybody can tell me how it will affect? Globalization is affecting environment also. Anybody, and you know, or you all know about this thing.
Mam, automobiles.
So environment kaise ho? We are talking about the globalization. If you remember, I have started the chapter with the name of MNCs, multinational companies. And in 1984, whatever happened in India? Any disaster? Man-made disaster? Anybody remember the disaster? Anybody? 1984.
Bhopal tragedy.
Yes, Bhopal gas tragedy. And the company, which country?
America ki koi company thi.
American company, Union Carbide. And why at the time globalization was not in India, but still Union Carbide established their plant in India, because in India rules and regulations were not so strict. Automatically, and when this situation occurred, what happened on the environment? So MNCs affect, if in India, you just see in India, maximum MNCs, mall culture. So it affects the environment also. Continuously AC chalte hain. So this is the, so you just imagine we all are living in a globalized world and it is a part of our life. And now we cannot imagine our life without this globalization. Though Indian government has banned Chinese apps, but still, do you think completely banned on all the items of Chinese? It is a slow process. Because nowadays, maximum countries of the world are not in favor of China because of this disease.
COVID-19.
Because all the countries of the world consider that this is, it is due to the China. They are blaming. And that's why World Bank is also not, World Bank initially, world, according to World Bank, even we have discussed in this portion in the geography also. It is a very interesting topic also, along with the important topic also and reality also. World Bank pressurized all the developing countries to remove their trade barriers. And if our government is putting ban on Chinese apps, that means our government put barriers. These are called barriers. So our government is putting barriers, and according to WTO, no barriers among countries. But when our government put barriers, WHO has not said anything. because now all the countries, maximum countries of the world, especially developed countries, America, Russia, France, they are not in favor of China because this is due to the COVID-19. So now this is globalization. It is the process of rapid integration or interconnection between countries. Now, economic globalization. Since we are studying in economic globalization, cultural globalization bhi hota, it is the process of rapid integration or interconnection of investment, production, distribution, employment, and trade among countries of the world. Now, few important terms which you should know about the chapter. First thing is MNCs. We can say it multinational companies or multinational corporations, but the actual word is multinational corporations. That means the companies which have their businesses in more than one country are called MNCs. And the example is Pepsi, Nike, Apple, Microsoft, etc. And now it is within your reach. Next is investment. I think everybody is aware about the investment, very famous word, very common word. But the money that is used to assemble the factors of production. If you remember in 9th class, we have done factors of production.
Capital.
Not only capital, everything, investment, yahan par to money hai.
Yes, ma'am.
Because capital mein bhi aapke, there are two types of capital.
Raw capital and
capital, physical and human capital. You are just talking about the physical capital, but I am telling about physical capital. And India is rich in physical or human capital?
Physical.
Human capital.
Physical.
Yes, India is physical. Rich in human. No, India is rich in human capital.
Human capital.
And that's why maximum call centers are in India. Maximum call centers. Call centers mein kya hota hai? We'll start in the chapter. So they are providing services. In call centers, they are providing services. But here we are just discussing about the money that is used to assemble the factors of production like land, building, machinery, etc. are called investment. But if investment made in a country by MNCs originated from some other countries is called foreign investment. So ye to ho gayi hamari foreign investment. Along with this, foreign trade. The trade, little bit we have discussed about this thing, and that is foreign trade means trade among different countries. Trade among different countries, that is called foreign trade. And it includes, there are two components of foreign trade, that is export and import. If trading is going on, automatically buying or selling. If we are buying, that is called import. If we are selling, that is called export. So these are the some keywords of the chapter. Now again, beta, why don't you mute your mic? If whenever I will ask a question, after that you can start. If I will mute you, so we cannot discuss. Only one way interaction will be there, and I think you will not like it. So it is your duty. You are not the kid one. So now when we were talking about the colonies. Colonies, kaisa? During the colonial period. India exported raw materials and foodstuffs, and what were we imported? Finished goods, as we have discussed in the First World War. After First World War, when Mahatma Gandhi started the Satyagraha movement, that is called Satyagraha movement, that is non-cooperation movement. And according to this movement, it was having two based, or wo kya base, boycott of foreign goods. Boycott of foreign goods and adoption of Swadeshi. When will adopt the Swadeshi? When will adopt the Swadeshi? Automatically, Indian industries will flourish. And same is happening nowadays also. Same is happening nowadays also. So previously also trade was the main channel connecting distant country. Now the distance between countries reduced. Have you ever heard this word, this statement? The world is shrinking now. The globe is shrinking. I think many times I use this word. The globe is shrinking nowadays. And what is the reason? We are living in a due to the development of means of transport and communication, distance between among countries reduced, and we are becoming more closer. Now we have discussed about the MNCs also. Initial step for globalization, we require MNCs. Multinational corporation transform the shape of the trade, which existed in middle of the 20th century. And these companies, like East India Company, because you are very much familiar about the East India Company, these companies control production or deliver services in more than one nation. And how do they work? Set up offices and factories for production in regions where labor and other resources are available at cheap rate. अब ये जो MNCs हैं, how do they work? ये प्रोडक्शन कैसे करते हैं? MNCs set up offices and factories for production in regions where they can get cheap labor and other resources. If you remember in 8th class, you have done factors affecting location of an industry. If you remember, you have done this. And
yes.
Factors affecting. So same manner, MNCs also set up offices and factories where they can get cheap labors and other resources. And why MNCs do this? This is done so that the cost of production is low and the MNCs can earn greater profit. And if you will, you have opened the book also? All of you open the book?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, okay. One is enough. So now one student will read the case study of spreading of production by an MNC. Akshit, you will start reading. Have you opened the book?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Start reading. and open your video also. And all of you, just please open the videos. Your Sakshi start reading, spreading our production by an MNC.
A large MNC production industry equipment designed its product in research center in the United States and then has the components manufactured.
And others
in China.
Will mute their mic. Others, mute their mics.
Are then shipped to Mexico and Eastern Europe where the products are assembled and the finished products are sold all over the world. Meanwhile, the company's consumers here is carried out through call center located in India.
Okay, now what we have, you have learned is that a large MNC producing industrial equipments जिसकी डिजाइनिंग कहाँ हो रही है इन यूएसए एंड देन कॉम्पोनेंट्स मैन्युफैक्चर इन चाइना एंड देन शिप टू मैक्सिको एंड ईस्टर्न यूरोप वेयर द प्रोडक्ट्स आर असेंबल्ड एंड द फिनिश्ड प्रोडक्ट्स आर सोल्ड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड इन द मीनवाइल कस्टमर केयर दैट इज कॉल सेंटर्स वेयर इन इंडिया So you, in this example, MNC is not only selling the production, selling its finished product globally, but more important, they are producing goods and services globally. You just see, एक चीज को बनाने में many countries are involved. कहीं पर कुछ हो रहा है, कहीं पर कुछ हो रहा है. That means production is organized in complex way. पहले क्या सिस्टम था एक जगह सामान बना और दूसरी जगह पर बेच दिया गया But now you just see how many countries are involved only in one production. So the production process is divided into small parts and spread out across the globe. अभी जो हमने example देखा China provides A cheap manufacturing location. आज भी आप देखते हैं maximum goods are manufactured in China. Mexico and Eastern Europe useful for the closeness to the markets in US and Europe. India highly skilled engineers who can understand the technical aspects of production.